a simple one for the Penguins tonight. Win, and they're in. Two more points to their name punches their postseason ticket, and they'll aim to do just that as they open up a home-and-home with the Detroit Red Wings in Detroit, Michigan at Little Caesars Arena. Power play for the Red Wings, who went 2-for-5 on the man advantage against Boston the other night here in Detroit. In the slot, it comes to Athanasiou. Side of net, saved by Matt Murray. Oh, a remarkable stop by Bertuzzi at the side of the cage.
That might be up for save of the year. They are stunned. Absolutely stunned here at the Little Caesars Arena. And I am stunned also. I can't believe what I just witnessed with my eyeballs. That save by Matt Murray.
Oh, my goodness. Puck comes into the far corner of the Pittsburgh end, played by Detroit. They had done so with a high stick, and that'll stop play as we get another look at this one. Matt Murray.
That's sick. That is just sick. Just never giving up on the play. As Andreas Athanasiou goes backdoor to Tyler Bertuzzi, and he basically has a wide open net. Matt Murray, just with those long, lanky arms, throws his glove hand right on the goal line and robs Bertuzzi. And the referee just got the thumbs up from Toronto.
Oh,
they want to take a look at it. And this might be over the line. This might be over the line.
Let's go down to ice level and check in.
After a video review, it was determined that the puck completely crossed the goal line. Therefore,
yeah, like I said, there was one angle. You watch four or five different replays, and you go, oh, that's close, but I'm not sure. And then there was one replay that you could kind of see through the netting, the webbing, I should say, of Matt Murray's glove. And you could see the puck had completely crossed the goal line.
So it'll be Tyler Bertuzzi's 20th of the year. Back in the Pittsburgh zone, the Penguins have the puck. 28 seconds to play. Here comes Crosby with speed in the attacking zone. Down the left wing, cross-ice pass. Kessel, a shot, he scores! And the Penguins answer late in the first. 21 seconds to go. Phil Kessel on the board. It's 1-1.
I salute you, Mike Sullivan. A little tweak. A little bit of your pixie dust that you throw into the lineup there. You throw Phil Kessel up with Sidney Crosby, and bam-o, you get magic in a bottle. And I tell you, I could hear Sid yell for that puck from Jake Gensel. Hip, hip, hip. And he gets a perfect little pass from Jake Gensel on the breakout, and then explosion. Sid through the neutral zone, and next thing you know, you blink, Josh, you got a two-on-one perfect pass from Sid to Phil, and he one-times it past an outstretched Jimmy Howard, and we are tied at one. Oh, is that a big goal towards the end of the first?
Plays it ahead for Larkin. Behind his own net for Nicholas Cronwall. Swings it up the right wing for Bowie. He'll pass it forward for Larkin over the Penguin line. Down the right wing in the near circle for Helm. Back across, has a man, a shot. They score. Pretty pass from Helm to Bertuzzi. He beats Murray up high. And it's 2-1 Detroit.
Wow, is this line on fire? That just is too easy. That's like morning skate stuff. The bingo, bango, bongo, the tick, the tack, the toe. And this one's very close to being offside, but I think it's going to be onside as Larkin's able to use his speed to gain the zone, throws a little saucer pass to Darren Helm. And then he throws a beautiful backhand saucer pass to Bertuzzi, and from a tough angle, he goes short side, blocker side, from down near the goal line, up over a sprawled out Matt Murray. And the Wings have their lead back, 2-1.
For Philip Aronik, out to the neutral zone. Gensel turns it the other way for the Penguins. Up the right wing for Crosby in the far circle. Holding on the backhand, centering in front. It skips back to Gensel with a shot. Save made by Howard. He never saw the puck. It went right into him, and he hangs on.
That was unbelievable. And Jake Gensel is skating by Jimmy Howard. He's actually going to have a little chat with him here. Jimmy Howard was looking to his left. He was almost hugging the left post. I think he thought that the puck was down on his feet. So three quarters of the net is wide open, and Jake Gensel in the slot shoots it right back into Jimmy Howard. That really was unbelievable.
Mantha leaned on by Matta there. Schultz has it. Backhands it up the far wall for Gensel. Swings it to the near side for Crosby. Over the center red and now the attacking line. Crosby at the right circle. Drifts to the slot. Drops it there for Gensel. Shoots one. Save made. The rebound poked away from Crosby. And back out to center. Look out here, Mantha. Down the right wing. One-on-one with Schultz. Shoots it. Save made by the right pad of Matt Murray. And he hangs on. Pickens to the near side for Philip Roenick. Knocked off the puck, but Larkin is there to flip it out to center. It's knocked down by Gabranson. Look out here, Mantha ahead of the defenseman. Cuts it on the forehand. He shoots and scores. Well, there's that speed. Anthony Mantha right past Marcus Pettersson. Gives the Wings some insurance. 3-1.
I tell you, it's remarkable, really. It is. Nobody talks about how fast these guys are. As I mentioned, Mantha has a different stride than Athanasiou or Dylan Larkin, but this guy can flat out fly. And all this is Dylan Larkin flipping a puck in between Gabranson and Marcus Pettersson, and Anthony Mantha just takes off, and he just blows right by. He's probably about 8 feet behind Marcus Pettersson, and it's a slow dribbler that Matt Murray can't come out and play. He's in between because he knows Mantha has good hands. If he comes out and plays it and Mantha walks around him, you're thinking, why isn't he just staying back and play goaltender position? He's hoping that Marcus Pettersson can get there, and Mantha just blows by him. Goes backhand, forehand, empty net, slides it in, 3-1 Wings.
Cross ice feed, Bukestad fans on the shot. Now Crosby, side of the net for Kessel, pokes it off the outside of the cage. And now Cronwall picks it up for Detroit, finds Bertuzzi, swings it across for Mantha, looking for the empty net. He's got it. Anthony Mantha scores his second of the night, and the Red Wings are up 4-1.
Well, the Penguins were moving around, Josh, like they were just down one goal. They were down by two, and nobody really wanted to be a shooter. And then when you had finally got it around to a guy that could pound a one-timer, Nick Bukestad shanked one off the heel of his stick. I almost felt that Nick was trying to pass it instead of shoot it, and he was totally in between. Should I shoot it? Should I pass it? He ended up shanking it, and shortly thereafter, the Wings were able to move it around and get it to Mantha. And from about 130 feet, he rips it into the top corner in the empty net, 4-1 Wings.
Holding on to the puck as he knocks it out the center with 8 seconds to go. Taro Hirose is shot from deep glove by Murray. He'll play it behind the Penguins net for Matta with a second left. And that postseason berth will have to wait another day for the Penguins, at least for now. They fall 4-1 to Detroit here at Little Caesars Arena.